think rice paper is incredibly versatile since with the right adhesive, it can be applied to almost any surface. It's colorful, the designs are beautiful, and they lend themselves to all kinds of projects. Debuting today is a new collection from Elizabeth St. Hilaire, four tropical fish, and a new Joggles black and white group that includes six designs. In this video, I'll show you ways to create with the fish, how to add color to the black and white designs, and how easily most designs transform themselves into backgrounds. Links to the products can be found in the expanded description below. Let's start by taking a look at the 10 rice papers, and I'm going to begin with Elizabeth's four. So these are, they're not just fish, they're tropical fish that Elizabeth collaged in the same way that she makes her paper paintings. So with these four sheets of rice paper, you have an opportunity to work with some of her art. These are A4 sized sheets, and the fish are going to measure anywhere from about 3x5 upwards to about 4x7, and for the jellyfish, which you'll see in 1 second. So these are good sized pieces. They're going to make a statement in your projects. Let me show you these, and then I'll bring in a couple of things that I've worked on. So we just named these A through D. So this is tropical fish A. This is tropical fish B. Here's the jellyfish I mentioned. That's on tropical fish C. And then we have tropical fish D. Now we'll have these set up so you can buy them individually, or they'll be available as a set of four, so you grab them all with just one click. So here are a couple of samples. Now I will tell you that this is nothing like what Elizabeth does. This is my poor attempt to kind of imitate her art. But the nice thing is all the work has been done on the fish for you, so you get all of the beauty of the way that she created them. This is an 8x8. You can see it's thick. It's a gallery depth wood panel. All I did was put some color on there, and then I used gel medium to go ahead and collage the fish on. This is another piece that I've worked on, and you can see I have a portion of a fish here. This is a 5x7 index card that has one of our, this is undulate, this is one of our creative cuts on top. If I hold this so the light catches it, you can just see I used one of the Folk Art Dragonfly glazes on top of that black index card, and then I came through and I layered some other elements on there too. All right, now that we've seen Elizabeth's tropical fish and got some idea about what you can do with them, let me bring in the six designs of the black and white collection. These we did give, or I did give, individual names to, and they too will be available as a set of six. So this is Delphinius, French script, that's pretty darn obvious, as is music. Then we have Old World Maps, a toy catalog page, which I think is kind of fun, and then these big blocky letters that are words. When you are working with black and white papers, you can use them as is, or you can add color. So I'm going to show you a couple of samples where I used them as is. Though there is color on this page, it was applied after I had collaged the elements on the back. So this is a little bit of a strip from the music sheet. This is words, and this is French script that I added a little bit of, again, yellow paint after the fact, and then I put some turquoise paint, and then I went in and I spattered. So you can see, you can collage very easily with these, you can add color afterward, or one of the things that I like best about rice paper is how simple it is to get a very effective background by just applying the paper to your surface, whether it's a page in a journal or it's a card front. But with all of that said, if you want to add color to rice paper, it's pretty easy to do. So I have a couple of examples here. Well, I have one example, and I'm going to work on a piece. So this is words, and I used three colors of Tim's Distress spray stains on them. These are dye-based, so they're transparent, just like dyes, ink sprays are. And that means that when you add them, they're not going to obscure the lettering. When you start to work with paint is when things become a little bit different, because most paint is opaque, or it's not nearly, if you have a transparent paint, it's not nearly as transparent as you would get or when you work with just the dye sprays. So I'm going to put a little bit, this is one of the Finnebert Art Alchemy paints, I'm going to put a little bit out here. Now these are particularly, these are going to be a particular example of a paint that is going to, if you're not careful, it can obscure some of what's on here. Now maybe you want that and maybe you don't. That's kind of a function of what it is you're doing. So I'm going to wet the paper because I find that it's much easier to get wicking and blending if the paper's wet. Although you do need to keep in mind that you can't rub endlessly on that paper, because if you do, it's going to pill a little bit and eventually you can tear right through. This paper is 30 GSM. So I'm going to water this paint down a little bit and I'm going to start applying it. Now, if I wanted, not using this paint, if I wanted to make certain that I didn't do anything to obscure the print that's on the rice paper, I would work from the back. But because this paint has sparkles in it, and I love sparkles, this actually works really well. I can add a hint of color and some of the sparkle without really doing that much to obscure the print, in this case, the music that's on here. Now, if I wanted to, if I was working with a paint that wasn't super sparkly like this one, applying it from the back wouldn't really make a darn bit of difference, which would allow me to get color without adding any opacity or doing anything to disturb what's on the front, you know, what's printed. But if I want to come in and I want to go a little bit heavier with this, you can see that I can do that. And if I add a little bit more water, I can get that mica to move around a little bit. So you have the opportunity to do pretty much whatever you want here. However you want to do it, I'm certain that it's going to be fine. And when it comes time to work with the paper once it's dry, you absolutely can apply more paint on top like I did on that sample that I showed you a moment ago. So this is some very basics to work with the papers. Up next, I'm going to bring in ideas for backgrounds. We can die cut rice paper and how you might want to back a piece of rice paper when that is a factor in how you're going to use it. Backgrounds with rice paper can be as simple as what I did here, which is to apply French script to this page. No color, no nothing, on it went and the background was done. Or, as I showed you previously, you can take bits of papers and collage them with bits of other things. That's, I think, really demonstrates the versatility of rice paper. You can do pretty much anything you want with this stuff. So this is an A7 card. It measures 5x7, and I've already put a piece, you can see the gloss on there, that's the backing paper on the sticky stuff. Now I used 6x12 sticky stuff because this card at 5x7 is too long to use a piece of the 6x6, and it can be a little bit time consuming to put strips of the narrower stuff on, so I just went and took the easy route. So I've got this ready to go. I'm going to take the backing paper off, and I'm actually going to work from the back. I'm not too worried about what part of the design I get here. I just want the color and I want the pattern. So I'm going to apply this face down. I'm just going to kind of look up over the top of this, and I'm not going to try to line up two edges. I'm just going to line up this, what is basically the spine of the card right here, and then I can trim. Now, if it's not perfect, it's certainly not the end of the day. Not the end of everything that we know. And so now it's just a matter of grabbing some scissors and using the card kind of as an edge that you run the scissors up against and go ahead and trim this off. Takes 2 seconds to do. If you want to do it in a paper cutter, you certainly can do that. I tend to use a rotary cutter and a mat and a ruler, but we all have our methods that work and that we're comfortable with. But for the sake of making this as quick as possible without dragging in more equipment, I'm just going to go ahead and trim it. And so here, let's get rid of those scissors, here's my card front, and it's ready to go. Now what I'm thinking of doing is, because I don't necessarily need to see all of this, it's busy and there's a lot of color, I'm thinking of layering one of the 4x6 index cards on top. So I've got them all here. I tried the gray, this is wet cement, I kind of like that. The craft, I'm not quite as fond of, although it certainly would work. And then we've got watercolor, but ultimately I think I like the black the best. It simply works with those black letters, and once I get this on, now I can start thinking about a sentiment and a focal image, whatever that ends up being. So now let's talk about die cutting rice paper. It's actually very easy to do, and it kind of, what you see kind of depends on the die that you use. So this is one of Tim's that's named Bubbling, and these were both cut from Old World maps. Now the thing to keep in mind is that the more open space and the less paper you see, obviously the less of the design you'll see. But on this one, which is one of the Creative Expressions, it's Sam Poole, it's named Dappled Ovals, here you can see more of the design. And that obviously factors into what it is that you use, which paper you use, and how much of the design you're going to see. Now, admittedly, this is very thin. And so what I would do, rather than try to adhere that piece as is, Even if I used Artist Tack, it would be difficult to do because this is fragile. It's so tiny. This would probably work better with Artist Tack, but the easier thing to do, let's get rid of that. And I've actually got the die here. I haven't popped this out yet. The easier thing to do is to put sticky stuff on the back of the rice paper before you do anything else with it. So when you get sticky stuff, and all right, so here's my 6x12 pack. When you get sticky stuff, there's release paper on both sides. So you peel the release paper back on one side. Here's the sticky stuff. You apply it to your rice paper, and then you're left with another backing piece that you can work with. So this isn't sticking to everything before you get a chance to cut it. And so that's what I did here. I've got this die cut. This is the bubbles, and I don't have anything to actually grab this and pull this out with, so I'm not going to be able to show you what it looks like. But you've certainly seen bubbles, or actually this is called bubbling. You've seen this. Now I just have it with the advantage of it's already got adhesive on the back, so it becomes a sticker and it's much easier to use. Now what also becomes stickers are these little pop-outs. Now sometimes what you get that pops out of the background of a die cut isn't particularly usable, but this has got sticky stuff on the back, and it's very simple to just go ahead and use it like a sticker. Now I wouldn't do this with the really teeny ones, and this is going to take me a second to get this started. I wouldn't do this with the really teeny ones because even I'm not that crazy to stand there and start picking the backing off. Almost got this. This is just a little bit fiddly. But with bigger pieces like this, you can do all kinds of fun things. So you don't have to just think about using the actual intended piece. You can think about using the bits that fall away too. And that applies to even if you're not using sticky stuff. Okay, so as we've seen, one of the defining characteristics of rice paper at 30 GSM is how thin it is, which means it's very drapable. You can form it around something that is curved or 3D. It is very easy to work with from that perspective, but there are times, and this is an example of one of them, when you have to think about what that drapeability means in terms of, well, it's upside down, when you work with this. And you can kind of see this a little bit here. If I hold this up, see how this is Dina Wakely's sticky back canvas tape. You see how the tape has conformed to the shape of the undulating creative cut that's on there? I didn't want that to happen. I'm a little less concerned about it here because these are small pieces, but hear that? There's layers here because the creative cut is sitting on top of that index card. So what do you do when you don't want your fish to do what this did? Well, the simplest thing that I can think of to do is to use a piece of cardstock, and that's exactly what I did. So here is the other half of that fish tail that was left when I trimmed it off, and you can see that I put some white cardstock on the back. So when I'm going to do this, I rough cut my piece, I grab some, this is Dina's gel medium, and I'm just going to go ahead, and I really don't like cleaning brushes, so I use my fingers. Now you can, of course, feel free to use a brush, but it is so much faster this way, or at least as far as I'm concerned, and it means I don't have to stand there and start rinsing brushes in the sink. I mean, half the time I've got brushes in a container of water, and they sit there for days and I forget all about them. And so with that in mind, I find my fingers work much better. So now, all I have to do is smooth this on there. I try to make certain that the gel medium is applied all the way across the top. You put that to one side, you wipe your fingers, you wipe your nonstick craft sheet surface here, and you're done. No brush cleaning, no nonsense, none of that stuff. So white cardstock is also handy. If I were applying something like this to, well, we'll just grab this, to a piece of black, you can see the color through that. And when this gets wet, it becomes, with gel medium, it becomes more transparent. Now, as we just saw, there are times when you really do want to use gel medium. So what you can do is the same thing I did here, which is to put this on sticky, excuse me, which is to put this with gel medium, if that's your choice, on a piece of white cardstock, and you won't affect the color that you see underneath. And as I said, this is going to get much more transparent when it gets wet. Of course, the other option would be to just use sticky stuff, because at that point, you're not going to wet this and make it more translucent. Although, again, if you're working on black, you might want to rethink that. So these are our newest rice papers. 4 tropical fish from Elizabeth and 6 black and white designs from me. I hope you have fun creating with them.